The views and opinions expressed on this program are not necessarily those of this station, JVC Broadcasting Management, or its sponsors.
Hi, I'm Karen Signoracci. For over 20 years, I've devoted my career to helping nonprofits reach their goals, increase their funding, broaden their donor base, and their community outreach. In addition, I work with my nonprofit clients to get the right people around the table to serve and execute the mission of the organization for its betterment and its service to the community. If you're considering starting a nonprofit, serve on a nonprofit board of directors, or are currently struggling to get your organization to the next level, please visit KarenSCS.com. That's KarenSCS.com. Let me know how I can help you increase your efficiency. One of the key components to a successful nonprofit are its board of directors. They are integral to the success by setting strategy, vision, and taking on fiduciary responsibility. Making key decisions is also part of this role. Please visit KarenSCS.com. That's KarenSCS.com. And let's speak about making your nonprofit and your vision. Hello and welcome. This is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio. I am your host, Karen Signoracci. I've spent the last 20 years working with nonprofits on building nonprofit boards and raising money and community awareness. And just my little PSA to start, I hope you'll listen and you'll be inspired and you'll hear something today that you can bring back to your family, to your place of business, to your community. And there's so much good work being done on Long Island. We're going to talk about some of it today, and you can get involved. You can do something. So think about what you can do, what you'd like to do. My other quick PSA, it is a little summery time here on Long Island, and there is still events. There is still money to be raised. There's still things going on. So if you need a break, yes, of course, take your break, but there's plenty of things and no shortage of things to do. So I have a guest today with me. Her name is Shannon Boyle. Hi, Shannon.
Hi, Karen.
Shannon is the executive director of Newground, and Newground knows the burden of homelessness for families, specifically veterans, and they work to get families and veterans out of that cycle of poverty. It's not just the homelessness part, there's other services, and Shannon's going to tell us all about that and the great work Newground does. Shannon and I have known each other for quite some time. We are both fond of the beach, often see each other in Long Beach, and she's a great person to know. She is on the spot, a tremendous resource, passionate, and I'm so glad you're here today, Shannon.
Yes, me too, Karen. Thank you so much for inviting me.
You're welcome. So I know we have to get all this other stuff checked off. On The Big Picture, we always talk about food and wine a little bit because, you know, I love food and wine. So you have to tell me real quick if there's anywhere you've eaten recently or anything you've made that really stands out that we need to know about.
Honestly, the place I go the most is sushi. My 3.5-year-old absolutely always wants sushi for dinner. So that's a main go-to for us.
That's a good one. That's great. And healthy.
Yes.
And, you know, we always like to support local businesses here.
Yes. So. Yes. There's so many great places in Long Beach. If you haven't been down this summer, come. There's great restaurants. Bright Eye Brewery.
Yes.
Right in the center of town. Really fun.
And truthfully, they've been very good to the community.
100%. They've partnered with us on a couple of events. Our upcoming annual 24-hour bike ride on the boardwalk. We have our after party there. They're supportive of so many different nonprofits and charities. So they do a great thing. And what's really fun is you go in there, you get to enjoy their beer, and you can order from any restaurant you want in town, and they'll deliver the food for you. So
that's great.
Yeah, you can have your favorite sushi there, pizza, whatever you want.
All right, folks, you heard it here. Bright Eye Brewery in Long Beach, doing good work. Have your meal delivered there, and you can't go wrong.
Yes.
All right, so we're going to get to the after party for that ride, but first, tell us about Newground.
So Newground, near and dear to my heart, was started in 1991, and the mission is to help break the cycle of homelessness and poverty for the veterans and families that we serve. And we really look at the big picture the whole story of what's preventing a veteran or family from being successful. There are so many barriers. There's education, there's financial literacy, there's employment, there's parenting, there's transportation, nutrition. All of these things are holding the families and veterans that we work with back from being able to lead successful, independent lives. So Newground began to address and create a long-term solution to poverty and homelessness. And for over 30 years, we have been helping Long Islanders break that cycle and move on to independent living, market rent housing, even quite often home ownership.
You know, so many people have a little roundabout way to the nonprofit world. And like I said in the beginning, you are a resource. You know Newground, obviously, in the work that you do, and you know the nonprofit world. And Shannon is also a tremendous networker. You always have. That's how we met.
Yes.
But how did you get here? I mean, again, most nonprofit executive directors have a little bit of a, you know, windy road.
Well, for me, I guess I did, actually. I went to school at Boston College, and I was pre-med, and I thought I was going to medical school. And during my junior year, I took the summer to study for the MCATs and all that. And after graduating, I was offered a job at a homeless women's shelter that I had been working and volunteering with part-time through my college career. And I decided, you know what? I'm going to put medical school on hold, and I'm going to work here for a year or two. And I never looked back. I realized that my goal was to help people. And I thought that I was going to do that by being a doctor. And I realized there were so many other ways that you could do that. And then I ended up going back to BC for my degree, my master's in social work. And when I relocated down to New York in 2002, I found Newground. And I have been there ever since.
And you're able to use the skills as being trained as a social worker in your role now, but also the ability to want to help and see the big picture and think strategically and build relationships and raise money. And you have staff.
Yes.
You have people that are social workers and other, you know, critical clinical professionals, but you can tie all that together.
Yes, definitely. When I became executive director, which actually is 17 years ago this summer, wow. Which I can't even believe it. It's that long ago. I definitely was very green. I knew social work and I knew homeless, but I didn't know a lot about administration and a nonprofit and fundraising and all of those things. So I learned, you know, on my feet doing the work, and networking was a really big part of that. I started networking actually just before I became executive director, and I learned so much from my colleagues like you and so many others that are experts in their fields that have taught me along the way.
Well, we've always tried to just have those tentacles go out, you know, the octopus arms. Mm-hmm. And, you know, for someone like you too at Newground, that's how you can get some potential board members, committee members, people to be at events, all of those things.
Yes, it's critical.
So tell us right now, what are you proud of? Where has it clicked? What is going on?
Well, over 20 years, there have been so many moments. I think from really early on in my tenure at Newground, one story comes to mind, which was the first college graduation that I attended for one of the children in one of my first families that I worked with. And she was graduating from Temple University down in Philly. And I drove down in horrendous torrential rain storm. And I watched this young woman walk across the stage sitting with her mom and her sister and her brother. She was the oldest in the family. And before the family found Newground, she was in high school and thought that she was going to have to give up her dream of college and get a job to be able to help mom afford rent for her family. And here she was graduating with a degree in accounting. Wow. And I watched her walk across the stage and grab mom's hand and said, "Congratulations, you have a college graduate." And she turned to me and said, "No, Shannon, we have a college graduate." You know, my heart soared. So
and it's those families. So Newground is not just helping the family, the individual, you know, that maybe did serve our country or whatever the case may be in their service. It's the family. It's the whole picture. And I think we see that in society. If you are able to help the family,
definitely
the ripple effect.
Yes. And this is a mom that contacted me then about 8 years later to say, my son is going to graduate from college this weekend, and I couldn't have made it here without Newground.
And it's years, that was before you, you know, the groundwork was laid.
Yeah.
And then you took the baton and carried it forward, and Newground has a tremendous presence in the community. And we're going to continue on that when we come back. We're going to talk about Newground and what's upcoming and their work in the community. This is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio. We'll be right back. Hello and welcome back. This is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio. I am your host, Karen Signoracci, and today I'm talking to Shannon Boyle of Newground, and we articulated in the first segment how we've known each other for quite some time, and I've always had great respect for the passion that Shannon brings. She told us about her background in getting her degree in social work, but I do want to share right now the website, Shannon. How can people find you?
Yes, it's simple, www.newground.org.
Newground.org. Okay, and now we were talking about you know, the families that you've touched, and how the, you know, the octopus arms have gone out, and the services that Newground provides, but tell us a little more about, you know, after this all this time, it's 30 years, a little over 30 years,
mm-hmm.
Where the organization is now and what's upcoming.
So exciting. We've had a big couple of years leading up to this. We did start in 1991, so we passed our 32nd anniversary in January. And we are now developing a project, an affordable housing project in partnership with a for-profit developer in Patchogue.
Wow.
And this is going to create 55 units of affordable housing. And 17 of those units are going to be specifically for families that we will be working with coming from domestic violence situations. So we're so excited for this project. It's so needed on Long Island. And affordable housing is needed for individuals of all income levels. And that is what this project offers. It actually includes housing at levels that the local school teachers can afford, the local nurses can afford, x-ray technicians at the local hospital. It has different levels of affordability based on income that really goes up to reasonable rates, because individuals like that, professionals like that, who are earning $80,000 a year, can't really afford housing on Long Island with what the costs are.
No, that's very challenging. And so how this has come together, I'm sure, over time, but, you know, what skills have you used and what has been kind of one of the common denominators in getting something like this done?
Well, again, I think it goes back to networking. Our two partners in this, I met through networking. Devin Kolka from the Kolka Group is
Hi,
a
Devin.
Partner.
You come on the show too.
He's fabulous.
I know him from a committee. He was on a committee that I was involved with for a client.
Yes. And he's very generous in the community as well, and is really excited about building affordable housing on Long Island on top of his other projects. And then our other partner is Georgica Green Ventures, headed up by Dave Gallo, and they have been developing affordable housing in different areas of Long Island. They have housing in Riverhead, in Great Neck. There's senior affordable housing that they are working on. They also have some in Brooklyn and New Rochelle. So this is something that they're very well versed in. And the complex is going to be beautiful. We are looking at breaking ground soon and being up and running by early 2025. And I think another skill set that you know, also besides networking that was useful through this was creativity. We have had to be creative about finding funding sources, applying for funding sources, and we've been successful. And that's what's making this possible.
Creative relationships, networking. That is very exciting. Patchogue, Suffolk County, it's going to have the influx, the inspiration, of new ground.
Yes,
which is terrific, and I'm excited that we were able to talk about that today, Shannon. Tell us a little bit about some of the partners in the nonprofit world that you've had over the years.
There have been many. I think not necessarily in the nonprofit world, but we are working for our veterans program very closely with the Northport VA, which has been really essential. Mm-hmm. And we have a social worker based on site there, usually 2 days a week, sometimes more if needed, to work with the homeless veterans that are struggling on Long Island. And we do have a very high number of veterans on Long Island. And of course, with that comes a high number of homeless veterans or struggling veterans. The VA's supportive housing program for homeless households has over 500 households in that program. So the need is great. And through that work, we've done work with some of the veteran shelters that are on Long Island, including Beacon House, which is a tremendous resource for our homeless veterans. We're also partnered with Island Harvest, for example. We have a small food pantry on site in our main office in Levittown, and so we are receiving food regularly from Island Harvest. The Long Island Coalition for the Homeless is a great organization that brings together a lot of the homeless agencies on Long Island to really try to tackle the challenges as a whole, as a group, in a unified way, which is essential. Last but definitely not least, we partnered for many, many years with Habitat for Humanity, Nassau County.
Right.
And Habitat Nassau recently merged with Habitat Suffolk mm-hmm. and became Habitat Long Island. Mm-hmm. But prior to that merger, over about 10 years, 7 of the last 8 families that they made homeowners were new ground families. So we helped a large number of moms and dads and children move from homelessness into homeownership through that partnership.
And that's a great testimony to two great nonprofits coming together for the greater good of the community and really putting their heads together, being creative and getting things done.
And long-term solutions. Long-term. That's what Newground mm-hmm. is really all about. We want to be giving our veterans and families a hand up, not a hand out, so that you know, in the future, they're able to manage their own lives, do what they need to do, and live independently like the rest of us.
And contribute to society and get involved in whatever they want to get involved in. Like we said, there's no shortage of things to do, and we never know what people's interests might be piqued by.
Exactly. We have a couple of our former clients that are now homeowners on our advisory board.
That's terrific. So, like I said in the beginning, Shannon, there's no shortage of events in the summer. So, tell us anything that's going on for Newground this summer that might be of interest for people that are listening.
Yes, as I mentioned, we are really looking forward to our annual 24 on the Boards event. This is a 24-hour bike ride on the Long Beach Boardwalk, and it's kicking off at 6 p.m. on August 26th, and we'll wrap up on the boardwalk at 6 p.m. August 27th, which is a Sunday, and then we will have our after party at the Bright Eye Brewery on Park Ave in Long Beach. So you can definitely come on down, join us at the after party. If you want to come down on your bicycle sometime between 6 p.m. to 6 p.m., the 26th to the 27th, you'll see our main leader of this event who created it riding his custom-made beach cruiser bicycle. It's not even an easy bicycle to ride for 24 hours, alongside a handful of people that do the whole ride with him and a group of others. You can join them for a lap or an hour, whatever you want to do. Rob Carlo is the leader of this. He created this event 5 years ago and has been benefiting New Ground for the past 4 years. And he is a retired FDNY firefighter who lost his younger brother in 9/11, also as a firefighter, and decided to do this on his birthday in recognition of veterans.
I've gone in the past, and that's why the date stays the same, but the day of the week changes.
Yes.
And it's a great event because people come out at all times. They're wearing the t-shirts.
Yes.
You've got the presence. People know what's going on, and it's different, and it stands out. And you've got community partners like Bright Eye.
Yes.
You've got Rob, who's on a mission.
Yes. Yes, to help our veterans as much as he can. And he's tremendous. This is his focus, and he puts a lot of time and energy into it. We have some great sponsors. We are going to be selling shirts again for the event this year, which are a lot of fun. Bright Eye is sponsoring the after party. We have a band. Come on down and join us.
So just the website one more time for New Ground?
And newground.org.
So I hope you heard something today that makes you think, that thinks about, have you thinking about how you could get involved in our community right here on Long Island. Thank you for listening. This is The Big Picture on 103.9.
The views and opinions expressed on this program are not necessarily those of this station, JVC Broadcasting Management, or its sponsors.